Hi, hope you're doing well this week. It's very nearly Easter. I want to share some verses that might not immediately appear to have much to do with Easter, but I think there's an interesting correlation. And this is from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 9. Jesus stepped into a boat, crossed over, and came to his own town. Some men brought to him a paralyzed man lying on a mat. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the man, "Take heart, son, your sins are forgiven." At this, some of the teachers of the law said to themselves, "This fellow is blaspheming." Now, their reaction might seem quite strong, but this is because they believed to be able to forgive somebody's sin in the way that Jesus has just said, you would have to be God. And so to step in and say, "Hey, sins are all forgiven," to them is blasphemy. No man can just come along and say this. And the story continues. Knowing their thoughts, Jesus said, "Why do you entertain evil thoughts in your heart? Which is easier, to say your sins are forgiven or to say get up and walk? But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." So he said to the paralyzed man, "Get up, take your mat, and go home." Then the man got up and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were filled with awe and they praised God who had given such authority to man. Now, I think this is interesting because Jesus knows from our point of view, the big deal is healing a paralyzed man. That's the spectacular miracle. It's not something you could just fake, and anybody could say the words, "Your sins are forgiven," and nothing would change. But if you say to somebody, "You're healed from paralysis," there has to be a change. Otherwise, you look like a fraud, a fake. You don't really have this power that you claim. From Jesus' point of view, healing a paralyzed man is the easy bit. It's the small fry. And for him, it's almost the taster to the bigger question of healing, of forgiving somebody's sins. And as we approach Easter, let's not lose sight of what Jesus does on the cross, that it's enormous. It's bigger than healing somebody, which to us is big. It's a big deal. But for Jesus, it's the big thing. He talks about it through the Gospels. The Gospels all end with the cross and the resurrection. That is the climax. That is the big thing that they build up to. Tomorrow is Good Friday. And obviously, as a church, we're putting out some stuff. I've done a message that I think would be great for us to share, if that's okay. On what the cross is about, and it's the central Christian thing. And it's because forgiving the sins of people is really, really difficult. The only way God could forgive our sin is with the cost of his own son. Jesus knows that from the off. Jesus knows how big a deal it is, and he gives a little taster of that in this story long before he even ends up there. So let's dwell on that. Let's let that weigh on us over the next few days. The seriousness, the severity of what Jesus needed to do on the cross, and the build-up to the joy that is the resurrection on Sunday. As always, if we can help with anything, do comment on this, get in touch, and hope you have a good Easter weekend.